Hello, everybody. Welcome back. Start with one of those. I'm here at Chuck Levin's with Uncle Drew. I'm going to officially start calling you Uncle Drew.
All right. Good to be with the king.
So today we are going to check out the Vintera, right?
Vintera, yep.
Which is vintage era.
Correct.
Right? And they have all the new models in. So we got an assortment over here. We have the 50s Tele. We have the Thinline Tele, which I guess is more 70s, mm-hmm, right? Because they're double humbuckers. Mm-hmm. We have a Bigsby Tele, which is what is that, 60s?
Yeah.
70 Strat, mm-hmm, and a Mustang and a Jaguar.
Yeah, with humbuckers.
With humbuckers. So let's, before we even pick up a guitar, what could you tell me about this line?
Well, the idea here is that you get a nice, affordable guitar, mm-hmm, good high quality.
These are made in Mexico, yes?
Correct.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And a nice assortment, you know, without spending a lot of coin. You know, mm-hmm, you're not going to be out of pocket. You'll have enough to get an amp,
right?
Instead of just a guitar. And then, mm-hmm, good quality, nice sound. Nobody can tell the difference, really, mm-hmm, 10 feet away.
Sure.
I wouldn't be able to tell you if that's a 70 Strat or not.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So
Vintera, vintage era, are these vintage spec?
Very close to it.
Okay.
A couple little modern refinements, some little fine tuning. Mm-hmm. We've learned a little bit since then.
Gotcha.
So
if you were to grab one and give us an overview, where do we begin?
Oh, I don't know.
You know what? Outside of tuning the Mustang and the Jaguar, I've never played a Mustang or a Jaguar.
Okay, well,
let's start
that.
There. Let's do something a little different. So, this is a first for my channel. You've never, ever heard a Mustang or a Jaguar on this channel.
So, this is what a lot of kids got these in the 60s as their first electric guitar.
Got it. Okay.
And it was the thing, and it was the thing to have, and it didn't get a lot cooler than that.
Mm-hmm.
And then you got the really nice working vibrato here, and these turn the pickup on in either position. It's a three position switch. They're off in the center, and what it allows you to do then is switch the phase, so you can have the pickups in phase or out of phase. You can get a really nice, like if you were going to do a funk rhythm, having these on out of phase,
mm-hmm,
it's just a really happening thing. Vibrato works very well on these. It's very easy,
yep,
to go, and volume and tone, pretty straightforward. This is also a shorter scale. It's 24-inch scale.
Ah,
so
okay.
It's a little bit lower tension, which, mm-hmm, is great for beginning players, or you can use a heavier string, go up a gauge, 11s will feel like 10s.
Gotcha.
On that. So that works really well.
Is this what they were using in Nirvana? Was it the Mustang?
One of them, yeah.
Okay.
They used a few things. They had the... But very... And just like the Jazzmaster and... Mm-hmm. And Jaguar became popular because they were inexpensive at the time on the market.
Let me untangle you real quick. Hold on.
So it was an affordable guitar, and you didn't feel too bad if you cut it up and put some humbuckers in it.
Mm-hmm.
You've got these special Fender turquoise bracelets, so you can scratch the entire face of the guitar at one time.
That's right. There you go.
So if I had just, say, the neck on, then I added the other one.
So what do the controls do again?
So now I've got both pickups on in phase.
Oh, I see.
And then here's out of phase.
Okay.
You hear that quack, quack, quack?
Yeah. So each selector is for each individual pickup.
Mm-hmm. This one's for this one. Now I come back into phase.
Almost sounds like a wah.
Yeah, and I could do it this way also.
Which now it's back in phase, right?
Yep. And it's back out of it. Subtle differences, but
right.
it's helpful. And then, of course, you got your volume and tone control. And this is placed so you can get
nice swells.
Great whammy bar, and if you're really enterprising, you can take it apart and turn it around and make it left hand.
Interesting. Okay.
It's got the old style Clisson tuners, which I really like for their simplicity. Mm-hmm. They work every time.
Right.
I mean, this is a no nonsense machine. It's grab it and go. Mm-hmm. And there you are, you know.
All right, let's take a look at the Jaguar. So does the Jaguar picks up where the Mustang leaves off?
Yeah, Jaguar is sort of another one where they were trying to give lots and lots of options. So you've got a preset jazz circuit up here.
Okay.
So you got a volume and tone, and when you select the up position, these controls take over and all of this is out of the circuit.
Interesting.
So you can have it like a preset dark control. Originally it worked only on the neck pickup. I'm not sure about this one.
Okay.
Then you have your pickup selectors, and then this is called a strangler switch.
Okay.
And what it is it sends the whole signal through a smaller capacitor, similar to what a baritone does.
Okay.
So if you're in a high gain circuit, you'll maintain some clarity.
Interesting.
Through the circuit instead of turning to mush. This is the full scale length. Actually, Jaguar is a short scale also. Jaguar is also a 24-inch scale,
Okay.
same as that. And then the Jazzmaster is the full-length scale. You got the Jazzmaster Jaguar vibrato, which has a mechanism inside here, and you can also lock it if you break a string or something. So a button will lock it so it won't warble all over the place. And then you got a tune-o-matic here, as opposed to the original rocking bridge. So this is much more stable setup. These are the kind of improvements that they've done.
Sure.
Easy to play.
Cool.
Really easy to play, and a different balance. It's a different beast when
they call it offset, right?
Yeah, especially when you're standing up. It's sort of, it hangs nicely.
Yeah. It's a nice looking guitar.
Yeah, matches my.
All right, so then we get to a 70 Strat, which let me grab this one over here. And this is, I guess, the giveaway for the 70s is the.
It's a couple things: the big headstock and the three neck.
Yeah. And the bullet truss rod. Does that come off, or you actually? No, that's as is, right?
It comes out eventually. It's a big. It's a big nut connected to the threaded rod.
So, what's your opinion on the three bolt?
It works fine if the neck pocket is well cut.
Got it.
It's fine. This also has the tilt neck, which allows you to get a very, very low action by sort of changing the geometry.
What do you mean a tilt neck?
There's a third bolt is a machine screw that goes into the neck.
This one?
Yeah, and then behind it is another little hole, and you can adjust an Allen screw so you can very slowly tilt the neck.
Interesting. Okay. Is that on every three bolt Fender?
On the original ones, yeah.
On the original, okay. Mm-hmm. Beautiful.
And you got the big headstock. A lot of people like that.
I like the big headstock.
Feel it gets a little more mass, and it went with the clothing of the day too.
Right.
This one has the tone control on the bridge pickup, which is really nice feature. So you don't get out there and then you're stuck. Thank you. Up the Strat sound. It also has a very nice sort of rounded over neck.
Yep.
Very similar to the 70s ones. I mean, they really nailed it there. Even the tuners with the F on them.
Yep.
So. And this has got the natural finish, the kind of thing you would have seen in the 70s where somebody would strip down their guitar.
Right.
And go to their woodshop class and refinish it.
Right. Interesting. Okay. And then, of course, we have a Bigsby. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna give that one to you.
So here you got your classic sort of Bakersfield setup, you know. And this one has the bridge that allows the strings to cleanly pass over the six individual saddles, so you can get your intonation right.
Mm-hmm.
Horseshoe Bigsby, as they call it, 60s rosewood neck, the old Cluson tuners.
Yep.
Nice straightforward thing, you know. And
I think we're on here. Oh, there you go, okay.
Fun. This is a nice responsive one. It's got a good spring. It's not too heavy. It doesn't require a lot of shoulders, so you can really get expressive with it.
And that's pretty rare. You don't often see a Bigsby on a Tele.
You do, but it's usually with a regular bridge, it's
right.
Hard. You got to start grinding and
right.
Moving stuff out of the way.
Yeah.
But this has got a nice line for the strings and a good sound.
Cool. And then we have a Thinline. Why did they do this in the 70s? Was it to make it lighter? Was it tone?
I think they were looking for something to compete with some of the Gibson sounds. You get a different sound with the hollow box.
I'll trade you.
All right. So you get a nice lightweight guitar, something you can wear all evening. It resonates a little differently because this wood starts to vibrate.
Something you could wear all evening. That's funny.
And then the wide range humbuckers, which have a real nice sound to them.
Tell me more about wide range humbuckers.
Basically, also a Seth Lover design, made originally with different type of magnets, so they had a very unique sound.
Got it.
You hear this a lot with Keith Richards in the Rolling Stones. He really likes these humbuckers, and this is about as American pie as it gets. You know, candy apple red and a maple neck and chrome.
Yep.
Lots of chrome.
Can you give us some Stones licks? You know any?
Maybe, yeah.
Are you doing an open tuning?
Yeah.
I am impressed. All right. Thank you. I was enjoying that.
Yeah, so it's all there. I mean, this is, you just take this and run with and play.
Right, it's a rock and roll telly for you.
Absolutely.
Okay, and then we have one more, which I guess is your traditional 50s.
Mm-hmm. Okay. It's the original design. Mm-hmm. So it's what was developed with between Leo and the you know, the working guitar players. They said, I need something that gets that country western sound, you know. Mm-hmm. That's what I want to have. And so thing, and very affordable.
So what else could you tell us about this line before we wrap up?
Come on down and try them out, man.
There you go.
That's really, you got to put it in your hands. It's like a car. You wouldn't buy a car, you know, without driving one. So it's, put them in your hands, because they really, the shapes of the necks, the finishes are beautiful, and it's got a good sound.
So if you had to pick just one, which one would you take home with you?
Right now, I really like the red one, the red thin line.
Really?
Yeah, I was enjoying that.
I think you sounded the best on the red and you did the vibrato real nice. You were definitely cranking out some good riffs on both of those guitars. So there it is. Drew, thank you so much. It's always a pleasure doing videos with you. You got to not only see, but you got to hear each of the, I think this is... That was guitar masterclass, how to play behind your head lesson right there. That's an expensive lesson. You got that one for free here. So anyway, we're at Chuck Levin's Washington Music Center in Maryland. Mm-hmm. And give these guys a call. And for those that don't know, Drew's actually, you're a tech here.
Yeah.
And for those that have tuned in regularly, knew he, we did a nice video where you set up my PRS. So check out the guitars if you're in the market for one. But if you need a setup, this is the guy right here.
Well, thank you.
And thank you again for being in this video. I'm curious to know what you think about this line. Leave that in the comments below. And if you had to take just one guitar.
Which one?
Which one would you take home? Curious to know. And for me, I think I'm with you. I'm somewhere between here and here. I like what you did with the Bigsby.
Yeah.
But this one definitely had the rock and roll sound. So, what do you think? Leave you with one of those, and we'll see you later.